Home Assistant 2023.1 is released and is full of new features. Let's have a quick look at what is new. Happy New Year! The first 2023 release of Home Assistant is out now. Let's see what it has to offer this time. Home Assistant will focus more on voice command support this year. That's great, but what can we expect? When I heard of these plans, I was not very enthusiastic in the beginning because voice commands are basically the same as physical switches to me. I think a real smart home should respond to the actions that you perform in your house automatically without having to push any buttons or turn on and off your devices using your voice. But then I started to think about it more and thought about use cases that could be very handy with voice assistants. I personally think that it would work great if voice assistants can be combined with actionable notifications. It would be great if your house welcomes you when you arrive home, for example. I can imagine it would work a little bit like this when I arrive home.
Hey Ed, welcome home. Do you want some coffee?
Yes, I would love to have some coffee.
Okay, I am turning on the coffee machine now.
Or, for instance, this use case.
I am sensing that it gets a bit cold in the house. Should I turn the heating a bit higher?
Yes, please.
Okay, Ed. To what temperature do you want me to set it?
Please set it to 21 degrees Celsius.
Consider it done, Ed.
This is not working yet in Home Assistant, but I think it will definitely be possible. Let's see how it evolves this year. One of the first steps to take in voice control is to add aliases to entity names. This was already possible in YAML, but now you can do this using the UI as well. It's a bit hidden, but when you open an entity and go to the advanced settings, you'll find an option to add aliases. You can even add aliases in your own language so that you can control your devices in multiple languages if you wish. Let me demonstrate this. Okay, turn on the bedroom lamp.
Prima, ik doe bedroom light aan.
And now in Dutch. Okay, zet de slaapkamerlamp uit.
Prima, ik doe bedroom light uit.
Awesome, isn't it? There have been some updates on Matter. I do have some devices in my home that support Thread and will support Matter in the near future, so when these are supporting Matter, I will let you know more about the Matter integration. It's now possible to manage Google Calendar events straight from Home Assistant. Furthermore, you can now edit existing calendar events on the local calendar as well. And you can now add various recurrence rules like once every 2 days, once every 2 weeks on Wednesday, etc. Nice. You can now use all the additional properties of sensors in automations. For instance, my air conditioning has some presets that I can now use in the trigger of automations. So it's now possible to create an automation that triggers if my air conditioning switches from the state off to the state heat, for example. In that case, I can automatically turn down the radiator in that room so that I do not use electricity and gas at the same time. Next to these major releases, there's much more added in this release. You can find them in this list and there are some functionalities that I really like. For instance, there's a new Reolink integration for your Reolink cameras. It only supports the cameras and NVRs and does not support the button on the new Reolink video doorbell yet. I created this video about the new Reolink video doorbell too. That device is totally awesome. Check it out if you didn't watch it already. The SwitchBot lock is now supported as well in Home Assistant. Brilliant! Now I can finally test my SwitchBot lock and create a video about it. And there is a great new integration, which is the Google Assistant SDK. This integration allows Home Assistant to interact with Google Assistant. With this, you can send text commands to Google Assistant to control devices that are supported by Google Assistant, but not by Home Assistant. And you can finally broadcast messages to Google Assistant speakers and displays without interrupting music or video playback. This was a really annoying thing in the past and is now fixed. I am really excited about the features of this new release. Let me know in the comments what feature you like most and what feature you're still missing. These awesome people over here sponsor me and make it possible that I can keep creating these videos for you. Thank you. I cannot do this without your help. You can also support me through Patreon, Ko-fi or by joining my channel. See the links in the description below. And please, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and smash the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.